20 years ago, it seemed like a modest venture with an overambitious name, Hitsville, USA. It was begun by a songwriter, Berry Gordy Jr., on an $800 investment. But it wasn't long before the hit records did, in fact, begin spinning out of this small Detroit company, beginning with their first million seller, Shop Around by the Miracles.
My mama told me, you better shop around. Oh, yeah, you better shop around.
Motown Records quickly became a multi-million dollar corporation built on the talents of a few black artists who lived in the Detroit area, like Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, Diana Ross and the Supremes, Martha and the Vandellas, Stevie Wonder, Marvin Gaye, and the Temptations. Soon artists from all over the country were heading for Detroit, trying to get on with Motown.
Motown was a magnet. If you were in the music business at all, you wanted to go to Motown. So it just all would just come right there where he was.
Yeah. It was the main thing happening for black artists. Right. I mean, you know, it was no place else for a black artist to go to get major attention in the real meat of the industry. Right. So Motown was the only one.
With the birth of Motown, Motown gave another kind of exposure to black artists in as much as it infiltrated to a great degree the white record market. And that had not been done prior to Motown Records. In fact, there were no black owned and operated record companies prior to Motown Records.
Many Motown artists remember those early years with the company as being part of a giant family, where in addition to singing, they did different jobs around the office. They were also tutored on the Motown image.
When you signed up with Motown Records, you didn't just sign as an artist or that. You had to go to artist development, which was going to learn choreography, harmony, vocal instruction, everything from stage presence to hygiene. You learn there, and you had to go. It's mandatory. If a person, the public, went to see a Motown review, then they were totally entertained because these people were polished before we even exposed them to the public.
On a cloudy day, when it's cold outside, I've got the month of May.
The classroom sessions are no longer a requirement at Motown, but the groups continue to polish their acts with choreography and costumes. Even for the Temptations, after 20 years, that still means working on dance steps. Motown Records has come a long way from that Detroit storefront to this high-rise office building in Hollywood. But even today, it is music, not corporate growth, that defines Motown. So the best way to examine this anniversary is to just listen to some of the sounds that have brought the company this far.
It keeps me a-trying, baby, for you. So won't you hurry? Come on, boy, and see about me.
Come see about me.
See about you, baby.
Come see about me.
Love child, always second best. Love child.
Put your hands together.
Then my only worry was for Christmas, what would be my toy?
We're gonna sing something.
When I was growing up listening to all those Motown records, I claimed many of them as my song, written just for me. Well, Tom and Jane, this time it is not imagination. The Temptations have given us our song.
Something. people know that we are on the Today Show.
For Today, Boyd Matson, NBC News, Hollywood.
Good evening, friends.
Mounds of sound, stacks of wax, full power coming your way, whether it's the Temptations or Toscanini.